I'm Gert Noskam. 12 years ago, I got an accident and had a spinal cord injury. So I'm not able to move my legs anymore.
My name is Henry Lorac. I'm the head of the Brain-Spine Interface Project at NeuroRestore. So NeuroRestore is a center where we develop neurointerventional therapies to tackle different neurological diseases such as spinal cord injury, Parkinson's disease, or stroke. So in our case, the study that we published focused on spinal cord injury in a patient who had a biking accident. And he had a lesion at the cervical level of his spinal cord. So he fell off his bike and he woke up, he was paralyzed of the forelimbs. So not able to move his hands nor his feet. After a few months of training, he could recover some function of his hand and arm, but he was not able to step and to walk. And in our case, what we did is to implant a system that could link his intention to move to his muscle activity back again and enable him to walk again. When you think about making a movement, you have these neurons inside your brain, in your motor cortex, that will send descending commands to your muscles through the spinal cord. And after a spinal cord injury, these cells, these neurons are still functional. And you can actually pick up the signal that they try to send to the muscles. Of course, this signal doesn't come down because of the injury, but we're able to decode the intention of the patient to make a movement. And we use this intention that is decoded in order to drive a spinal cord stimulation. And when he first joined the study, we implanted him with a spinal cord stimulator, so a matrix of electrode over his spinal cord below the lesion that could reactivate his paralyzed muscle. So with these small electrodes, by sending electrical impulses over the spinal cord, we can increase the excitability of the root and trigger muscle activity in his paralyzed limbs.
We do two different surgeries. There is one surgery at the level of the brain. We do two little craniotomy, put electrodes in order to record the brain signal. And another surgery at the level of the spinal cord, where we put electrodes on the top of the spinal cord, at the place that is responsible for leg movement. So between these two, there is communication, an electrical communication, a digital bridge that is then reactivated the legs.
Yeah, I think it's, as you say, it's a first step. It's one participant. What we are doing now is to make the technology smaller, smarter, and make it spreadable, diffusible to many other participants.